The summit has attracted over 4,000 participants, including 8 heads of state and government, 25 ministers of agriculture, 32 ministers of foreign affairs, scientists, among other partners. The summit is co-organized by the African Union and the government of the Republic of Kenya with support from various partners. It aims to foster crucial discussions on enhancing the value of land as a pivotal asset for farmers. Speaking during the opening ceremony, Her Excellency Ambassador Joseph Lowo Kero Sako, the Commissioner for Agriculture, Rural Development, Blue Economy and Sustainable Environment at the African Union Commission, emphasized the need for collaborative action and innovative solutions.
Let me begin by commiserating with the government and people of Kenya for the torrential rains and the flash flood across the country that have left an estimated of 210 people dead, destroyed homes and key infrastructure, leaving more than 1,000 people displaced. My condolences to the family that lost their loved ones. Last year, we're here in September for the climate summit, the African climate summit. So we have to take this agenda very seriously so that we can avoid all this loss of our citizens on the continent.
Over the next 3 days, participants will engage in dialogue to steer Africa's agricultural transformation while setting the agenda for its future food systems, a key item in the 50-year development plan, Agenda 2063.
We share common concerns regarding the future of our agriculture and of our food security. We all recognize that agriculture remains central to Africa's growth and poverty reduction. In Uganda, it employs nearly 70% of the population and contributes approximately 24% of the gross domestic product, generating 40% of the country's exports and 60% of raw materials for our industries. I guess it could be close to the same picture in our respective countries.
The soil health conversation is unique in all countries world over, given that we all have to feed our people. I'm glad that our experts in Kenya have participated in the development of the soil health initiative and the 10-year action plan and the different platforms, and appreciate the leadership of the AUDA, NEPAND, and the African Union. Soil fertility depletion has been cited as the fundamental root cause of declining per capita production arising from continuous mining of soil nutrients, inappropriate farming practices, including use of blanket fertilizer recommendations.
This year's summit is held under the theme Listen to the Land, which seeks to evaluate the state of Africa's soil health while reviewing the progress made since various commitments by African leaders to boost fertilizer use for agriculture growth in the continent.